Hey, let's do some purple sheets. I don't know if they're purple for you guys or not, but let's do these sheets. This has the chicken, the platypus, the kangaroo, and the lion on it. So we're talking about the loss and the gain of different genes as time goes on. This one's a weird, little bit weird in terms of its orientation for this cladogram. Kind of goes from the upper left down to lower right for that lion being the most advanced organism on this cladogram. So if you're looking at what's happened over the course of time for these particular proteins, when did the casein gene, what one is it gained? It was absent in the chicken and it was present in the platypus. So between the chicken and the platypus, we ended up getting the casein gene. So that would be a C there. So that one would go right there. There you go. And then from the platypus to the kangaroo, the platypus to the kangaroo, we had present, 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 absent, so we lost the vitellogene, so we have the V here with a line through it showing that it's been lost. And then from the kangaroo to the lion, from the kangaroo to the lion, we went present, present, absent, absent. So there is nothing that goes in this third box, which is the kind of annoying part about this type of question, is that there's just no answer in there. So this is correct, and that is the answer that you need to have for this one. All right, scrolling down to the animal cladogram there, looking at the evolutionary relationships among four animals and their traits. Select the boxes that identify the traits that each animal possesses. The frequently made issue and error here are the ones that people are checking the wrong boxes. This is what they actually possess. So you can do it in a couple different ways. You can either do it by organism or you can do it by characteristic. If you did it by characteristic, all of them would have a vertebra, so you would put a check in each of those boxes. Check, 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 check. The two pairs of limbs would be everything except the shark. So two pairs of limbs. We get the bullfrog, yes. The chimp, yes. The kangaroo, yes. You get all that. Oh, that's really draggy. Draggy and laggy. There we go. The mammary glands are only going to be in the kangaroo and the chimp. So the kangaroo and the chimp are going to have those. And then the placenta is only going to be in the chimpanzee. So there you go. That would be your answer to that one. A little sloppy, but I think we've figured out that sloppy is going to be the word until I figure some other way of illustrating this. This one we have to place our on question 22, we have to place these three characteristics as well as some of these organisms. We don't have to place all of the organisms, but we should place all of the traits. So I think the trickiest part here is what is a segment on this? And any organism that has a little white head is going to be the one that's going to give you the segment. So I like to start this one with wings because there's only one organism with wings. So I'm going to put the wings out here, and then we're going to call this organism A. I am going to call this organism A. So there we go. So I'm going to put organism A out bar. We'll do it like that. And then I like to call that one the wings. Now we also could have antenna. So antenna could go here, or the antennae could go there. And then that means that that would be, let's call this organism B. Boy, those Bs are difficult for me on the mouse. So B, aggressive, B, aggressive, B. All right, so that would be organism B, and this would be antenna there, so not to confuse it with the organism A. And then the last one is we have to place segmented body, but this organism does not have, this first guy up here doesn't have a segment, so we could put segments here. And if we did that, we could place, that would be it. We wouldn't have to place all the organisms. And we don't have to place all the traits. So we could leave that open because that would work. And it would be done if you felt like you needed to place this one in here for some reason. Oh, you know what you could do is you could put organism C up here. You could place organism C, and that would be a correct answer as well, as you could do that right there. And then just leave this guy completely out. You could have done it that way. There are a lot of different answers to it, but that's going to be probably the most straightforward answer for us for this particular environment. And yeah, there you go. So this one ended up at 4 minutes and 45 seconds. Stop.